This is the member management tutorial. We will show how to create and update information for each team member. With member management, you end up with a screen that looks like this. And you can edit and update the information for each team member from the Edit View screen that looks like this. So let's have Mark take us through this screen step by step.
There are two ways to get to your member management page. You can either click on your username here, upper left-hand corner. This will pull up the Edit View Member. Or you can go to your members icon and select your own member. Click the Edit icon, and it brings up the same window. Let's first navigate through the Edit View Member window. Upper left-hand corner are the available positions. This is where you can assign all the positions that you're available to either fulfill, if you're in the band, for example, or if you're an usher, or anything else that you might be scheduling for that matter. And this is your user information, first and last name, address, all that. The only thing that's absolutely necessary here is first and last name, as well as a username that gets created whenever you first add the member to your account. Also, security level is important. Administrator has administrative access to the entire account. Team leader lets you build playlists and events and manage the music and content side of it, whereas a team member has much more limited access and cannot edit anything besides viewing their own schedule, setting their own availabilities, and practicing with any music that's available. My schedule is an exact replica of what's on the home screen. This shows you any events that you've been scheduled for, lets you launch into practice mode, lets you launch the planner if you're scheduling this event, or accept or decline these positions. You can accept them here, you can accept them on the home screen, or you can accept them from the email that you'll receive whenever you send out the email notifications. Notification methods, you'll see here any notification methods you've added. In this case, I've got my own email address. It shows you whether this is the primary email, whether it's active, and whether it's validated. When you first set up the account, you have to validate your own email address. And whenever you add new members, you also have to make sure that those members have validated their email. So they'll receive an email. Once you add an email to this list, they'll click through the validation process. It's very simple, and this checkbox will then be validated. On the right-hand side, you can change your password, set your availability, drilling down into that. Unless otherwise specified, I am available. That's the default setting. You can also go in and add a new availability, whether it's a singular event, it's a weekly event. You can set a specific day. Once you've set one, you can then select whether that time frame you are available or unavailable. You can also delete these. However, it will always default back to unless otherwise specified, you are available. Under the member setting, this is where there are more settings that are pertinent to people with Samepage performance stations, but an important thing to note here is the show menu labels. And you can click this and it will display the menu labels on the home screen to help you navigate those icons better. I'm going to leave that on. Moving on down, you'll see the assigned to positions. Now, only administrators and team leaders can assign anybody to a position. So a team member cannot do this for security purposes. In this case, I'm going to go in and assign myself to the guitar position. You can select any available position from any of the position groups. Click OK, and you'll see them all displayed over here in the available positions. I can also use this add notification method to go add a new email address in the event that the validation email did not come through. You might want to try it again by simply adding a new notification path, like your email address here. You can delete any of these at any time, but you'll need to add it and revalidate if you've deleted one and you want to have a valid email address. Going back to the members home screen here, you can search through your list of members in the event that you have more than just the 7 or 8 that I have. You can also delete members as well as associate attachments to that particular member. To add a member, you simply click the Add New Member button. It brings up the same looking window, but this is the Create New Member. You'll need to give them a first name, a last name, and then a username. The username has to be unique. If it's not available, it will highlight in red, and then assign a security level. Once you click the checkbox, it will prompt you for a password. Both the username and the password will be emailed to this member once they have a valid email address. So it's very important to go ahead and add a notification method right here from the Create New Member. That's a quick overview of the members page.